We are living in the age of a space race. Two billionaire entrepreneurs are fighting to send us all into space. Elon Musk and SpaceX, Jeff Bezos and Blue Origin.
So who is going to get us to space first?
Blue Origin thinks it's the tortoise in the fable of the tortoise and the hare. The hare took the early lead in the race, but in the end, the tortoise won. The moral of the story is, slow and steady wins the race. It appears SpaceX is ahead.
Liftoff!
In May 2020, SpaceX became the first private company to send humans into orbit by flying two NASA astronauts to the International Space Station.
On the other hand, Blue Origin has yet to launch a rocket into orbit, let alone with humans on board.
Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos have slightly different motivations for going to space. Musk believes humans are at risk of becoming extinct because of climate change, the threat of artificial intelligence, or an attack on the planet. So we're more likely to survive if we live on multiple planets. Musk has made it no secret he wants to colonize Mars.
And it's very important that we do so as soon as possible, I think, while the window of opportunity is open. I call upon the public to support this goal.
Bezos has a slightly different motivation for going to space. He believes the Earth is irreplaceable and wants to preserve it for future generations. He wants to tap into the unlimited resources in space, specifically from the moon. There's a lot of ice at the moon's poles, which could be mined for fuel to power Blue Origin's space vehicles. Bezos ultimately wants to create something straight out of 70s science fiction, space colonies, large floating settlements holding a million people or more that can support animals and plants as well. The ISS looks tiny in comparison.
We can have a trillion humans in the solar system, which means we'd have 1,000 Mozarts and 1,000 Einsteins. This would be an incredible civilization.
In order for their visions to become a reality, they have to significantly reduce the cost of each launch, because usually a rocket is thrown away after one use. The focus is now on developing reusable rockets.
Specifically, reusing the booster, which is the lower portion of the rocket. It's the most expensive part. In December 2015, SpaceX landed its Falcon 9 booster back on Earth. That was a huge feat for the company. Meanwhile, Blue Origin has yet to launch any rocket into orbit. It is developing one with a reusable booster. New Glenn aims to go to space in 2021. It will be much larger than SpaceX's Falcon 9. SpaceX is now setting its sights on developing a fully reusable rocket called Starship to carry people to the moon, Mars, and back.
Even though it seems Blue Origin is far behind, do not count Jeff Bezos out.
Blue Origin's motto is Gradatim Ferociter. Apologies if I didn't get that quite right. Translated from Latin, that means step by step, ferociously. Bezos's company is quietly developing a rocket called New Armstrong that might be fully reusable. We don't know much about it as of the making of this video. The company is also getting better at launching and landing. In November 2015, its New Shepard rocket successfully landed back on Earth for the first time. The reason I said Blue Origin has yet to launch a rocket into orbit is because the New Shepard is not designed to reach orbit. It only travels to the boundary between Earth's atmosphere and space. It will be used for space tourists in the future.
One of the biggest differences between these two companies boils down to money, and it could explain why SpaceX appears to act with more urgency.
SpaceX has had to scramble for contracts to survive from the beginning. Musk threw his personal fortune into the company when he created it in 2002. When the financial services company he co-founded, X.com, merged with a rival and became PayPal, and eBay bought PayPal in 2002, Musk walked away with $180 million. He sunk $100 million into SpaceX and the rest into Tesla and SolarCity. But it takes a lot of money to run a rocket business. SpaceX had three failed launches before its Falcon 1 rocket made it to orbit in September 2008. That was the defining moment for the company.
Space operation confirmed.
But SpaceX was nearly bankrupt. Then a Christmas miracle happened. NASA came through with a $1.6 billion contract 2 days before Christmas. That saved SpaceX. On the other hand, Blue Origin is backed by the richest person on the planet, Jeff Bezos is, of course, the CEO of Amazon. He quietly started Blue Origin in 2000. He has been obsessed with space ever since the moon landing. Bezos sells $1 billion or more of his Amazon stock every year and puts it into Blue Origin. So his private space company doesn't have the same financial constraints. It's not under time pressure to be revenue positive. It can execute slowly and methodically.
At the beginning of the video, I asked the question, who's going to get us to space first? But maybe that actually was not the right question to ask.
Maybe it's not a competition with only one winner, and we shouldn't think of it as a race between a tortoise and a hare. There might be room for more than one company to win. After all, we are dealing with the infinite possibilities of space and the future of humanity.
Thank you so much for watching. I'm Cindy Palm. If you like what you saw, give us a like, and don't forget to subscribe to our new channel. I'm going to be doing a lot more videos just like this on topics that I find super interesting, and I hope to see you soon.